Latest on HIV cure news treatment, $26.5 million grant Scripps Research Institute. Hello folks, it's Mark Medicals teaching about HIV infection like HIV treatment, HIV symptoms, and HIV testing. Do you know what approach is Scripps Research Institute using to cure HIV? In this video, I will make a simplified version so that even your grandmother understands this HIV cure treatment approach. This HIV cure research is a collaboration of researchers at Gladstone Institutes, Scripps Research Florida, and Weill Cornell Medicine. The approach, dubbed HIV obstruction by programmed epigenetics hope, aims at blocking, locking, and excise HIV from your CD4 cells. The question is, how does block-lock-excise work? To understand this, you need this background knowledge, so here we go. From my last videos, I already taught you what happens when HIV soon enters your body. But to remind you, this is what happens. Soon after infection, HIV will wander around your body hunting for cells of your immune cells called CD4 cells. Usually, HIV infection occurs within 72 hours after exposure, a reason we tell people to take HIV PEP medications in less than 72 hours after exposure to HIV. After the HIV virus has identified your CD4 cells, it will attack and break into those cells. We humans have DNA as our genetic material, whereas HIV has what we call RNA. HIV uses a certain enzyme to change from RNA to viral DNA. Because the viral DNA now resembles the human DNA, the virus will insert its viral DNA into your DNA, will instruct your body cell to start following commands from the virus which infected you, thus using your own CD4 cell to manufacture millions of HIV viruses. After HIV has infected and broken into your CD4 cells, it usually follows either of the two options. 1. HIV may choose to become active and start multiplying into million copies. 2. HIV may also decide to lay dormant or silent for years. Your HIV medications only eliminates active HIV, but does not eliminate hidden or dormant HIV. It is this hidden or silent HIV that has beaten scientists and doctors, because no medications can reach it. Here is what Scripps Research Institute researchers are doing. It is not only HIV that inserts its viral DNA into your cell DNA. Other viruses too you have suffered from also insert their DNA into your cells. But, what differs from HIV is that, other viruses lie dormant forever in your CD4 cells. Silent HIV, on the other hand, uses a protein called TAT to turn itself on or off, and therefore, if you stop taking your medicines, soon you will have a higher rebound of viral load. Scripps Research Institute researchers have devised means of blocking the protein TAT, which acts as a key to making dormant HIV into active, and locking this protein forever. By doing that, people living with HIV could go off medications for good with no HIV rebound. Also using CRISPR technology, these scientists will easily excise your DNA harboring the viral DNA.